I'm Jim Kircher. Let's face it, good news has been kind of hard to come by these days, but I've got some. You see, things are looking up for the Ozark Hellbender and for the people who have been working for years to keep the big salamander from going extinct. Yeah, I know, it's a salamander, but it's actually kind of a big deal.
The St. Louis Zoo has reason to brag. Its hellbenders just laid a bunch more eggs. They've hatched another new generation. You can call it continued success, but it's taken years to get to this point. And the real success is not to be found in tanks in a zoo, but here, in rivers and streams in this one part of the Ozarks. It's the only place this subspecies of hellbender can be found. The Ozark hellbender, which can grow up to 2 feet long, may not be the most lovable of creatures. After all, one of its nicknames is snot otter. But when it was put on the endangered species list, it began to get, if not a lot of love, at least a lot of tender loving care. The Missouri Department of Conservation and the St. Louis Zoo have been working for years to bring them back by raising hellbenders in captivity and then placing adults back in their native habitat. A key part of the success story has been the artificial streams right here behind the St. Louis Zoo's home to reptiles and amphibians, the herpetarium.
These are animals we are breeding to send back into the wild into 6 different river systems here in Missouri.
These are the streams. They're in there now, right?
Yeah.
If I stood here long enough, would I ever see one? Or are they?
Actually, on overcast days like this, sometimes you can see them. They're usually under a rock or in a nest box with their heads kind of poking out.
Do I
see a crayfish?
Yeah. That I see.
Do they
eat crayfish?
Mm-hmm.
I know they. Yeah,
yes.
That's what they eat, right?
The hellbenders that live here are not on display. All of this was built to make them, not us, happy and healthy. Happy and healthy enough to make babies. Which sounds easy, but it was anything but. The Missouri Conservation Department's state herpetologist has been working on this for more than 20 years.
10, 15 years ago, I would have thought the future was not very good for this species.
Here's how it started. Hellbenders, whose population was getting dangerously low, were captured, males and females, in their Ozark streams and brought to the zoo. They were first put up in a stream-like pool in the research center, males and females. But they just didn't make any babies. So they thought maybe the hellbenders will be happier outside. And so 2 artificial streams were built with nesting boxes, flowing water, the current, the temperature, the minerals, all mimicking an Ozark stream. It took some tweaking of the water, but they finally got it right. And in 2011, fertilized eggs were found in the nests and brought indoors. They hatched. They survived. It was the first time anywhere that hellbenders had successfully been bred in captivity. And they've been building on that success ever since.
This year we had 6 clutches of Ozark hellbender eggs, so we're continuing to successfully reproduce this species and we're getting better at it each year.
So these are the clutches from these streams?
Yes, from these 2 outdoor streams.
From your hellbenders?
Yes, that's correct.
This year's babies will join thousands of others of different ages and generations that have been raised at the zoo. But this is important. The first successful hatchings came from hellbenders that had been caught in the wild. But it's now the zoo-raised hellbenders that are making babies.
This is really great news for the animals here in terms of having sustainable captive populations, knowing that we're rearing animals that can reproduce, but it's also great news for the animals we're putting back into the wild.
It's easy to keep track of the hellbender population in the zoo, much harder once they're back in the Ozark rivers.
Yeah, so every hellbender we put back into the wild has some sort of tag, a coated wire or a pit tag, so that we can identify that animal in the wild once we re-encounter it.
Is it difficult to keep track of where they are?
It's very difficult to keep track. I mean, we're releasing animals from 2 to about 6 years old. They're not the easiest to find.
But the ones they do keep tabs on seem to be thriving up to a point, because they still don't know if any of the zoo-born hellbenders have successfully reproduced in the wild.
That's one of our next big milestones. We have not seen it yet in the wild, but that's not to say it's not occurring.
But even if they do reproduce, what will be the survival rate and health of the offspring? Because there's the nagging question, what factors led to the population decline in the first place? One suspect is land use that has led to increased silting filling in their rocky nests. But there are other likely environmental and water quality issues. Continued testing might help zero in on that, because hellbenders transplanted from pristine zoo conditions are very likely to be able to tell you a lot about their new environment, which also helps answer this question. Why should we care about all of this?
Amphibians are incredibly important. We call them indicator species, so they're one of the first species that will notice declines in populations if there is problems in the habitat, and that's because of their sensitive skin, that we can often use them to indicate larger problems and disturbances for other species, and so they're really important. But they also play a critical role in the food chain, both as predator and prey.
Can we say at this point that we've saved the hellbender?
I don't think we can confidently say that yet, but I think we are definitely bolstering wild populations, and we are on the way for certain.
Is this animal going to go extinct in my lifetime in this state now? Very unlikely. However, we still got to get at the main causes of decline and make sure that they can sustain themselves, their populations into the future.
It's just, they're phenomenally different from us, and so it keeps me interested, and you can always learn more, and so that's what I think is really exciting, and that's what's been awesome about the Hellbender program. Each year we learn more about these amazing animals, and we tweak our program to improve our success.
For Living St. Louis, I'm Jim Kircher.